thank you all for coming out, and I really hope that you all enjoy the work that everyone has put in. It has taken a lot of manpower, and it has taken a lot of rehearsal hours for choir members, people giving their time effortlessly in making this all work. So sit back and enjoy.
From the throne room of God, the angel Gabriel is sent to bring good news, first to an elderly couple, and then to a young couple betrothed to be married. The message is essentially the same. God is about to act, and all of history will be changed forever, and you are a part of God's great plan. Zechariah, Elizabeth, Mary and Joseph will become the first to participate in this divine drama that is a message of good news to all creation. They are just ordinary people who God has selected to fulfill an extraordinary purpose, and through them, God's plan of salvation for all people will be fulfilled.
Oh,
From the moment of his birth, this new king will rule a most unusual kingdom. From the poorest of the poor, represented by the shepherds who watched their flocks by night, to the wealthiest of foreign kings who traveled for months to see him. At various times, each of them will kneel before him and offer their veneration, and if they have any, their gifts. Some will bring gifts which represent their wealth, status, and prestige, while others will bring a more modest offering, the gift of a talent or skill, maybe the beating of a simple drum to offer the new king.
Come, they told me, ba-rum-ba-bum-bum. sin had never punished me till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill I felt, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious.
Sometime after the birth, maybe as much as 2 years, the city of Jerusalem and King Herod will be greatly disturbed by the unexpected visit of foreign kings, the Magi. No one knows for sure how many came, but we know they came in pursuit of a star, seeking the honor and privilege to worship the new king and to share the gifts they had prepared and protected for him.
There was a night when some men beheld a
Even in the midst of overwhelming good news, there is often tragedy and pain. As King Herod learns the Magi will not be returning to unwittingly assist him in destroying this new king, he quickly turns to a new plan. He orders the execution of children, toddlers, and babies, all boys in and around Bethlehem, 2 years old and younger. It seems impossible to imagine the hardness of that heart or the grief of the hearts of so many who watched their own children put to death. No act could more clearly convince us of the brokenness of our world and our need for a Savior. Let us hear from the Gospel writer Matthew. A voice is heard in Ramah, weeping and great mourning. Rachel weeping for her children and refusing to be comforted because they are no more. Mary's baby boy will survive the attempts of King Herod to destroy him and will grow to fulfill the purpose for which he came to earth. Through his ministry and in the 2,000 years which have followed, Christ and his followers have continued to proclaim this message of good news. What the angel Gabriel proclaimed is still at the heart of this movement called Christianity. And just like Jesus, we continue to confront the Herods of our day, whose lust for power and acts of cruelty scar the beauty which God created. This story, which began so long ago, stays alive in us because its message still speaks so clearly today. It casts a vision of who we can be and offers endless possibilities for the world today.
Done. I would like to just, before we go, I'm not long for like prolonging the process by having a whole bunch of talk after the process, but I do want to say thank you so much to like I said again, everyone that went into making this happen. Pastor Larry, who did the narration, he wrote the narration, and he did exactly what I needed at the right time. to the young children for being soloists, and high school children for stepping in and being Mary and Joseph, for the dancers who stepped in at the last minute, which was absolutely awesome, and I thank them for that, and their director. Like I said, again, it takes a lot to make this work. The ushers, everyone to the office, people who did the programming. The office secretary told me that she didn't even have a template for it. So what do I want? And I said, well, I don't know what I want. Can I give you the information? And you do something with it. So like I said, several people in the audience in the choir for correspondence. And like I said, you all make this worthwhile. And I just wanted to, as part of the music ministry team at both Grace United Methodist and Murphysboro United Methodist, I did want to deliver God's message in a different way. And you all helped make that possible. And I thank you all so much. And Christy, who did like the set. And initially she said Christy Miller, which is really, really beautiful. Christy. So she asked me when we first showed up, and she asked me what I wanted, and I told her what I wanted, and she said, oh, that's all you wanted? I said, yeah. So next year, Christy, I want angels from the rafters, mechanical. So look forward to that. Thank you to my music crew who have worked diligently with me and changes, and they just did an awesome job with that. And like I said, there's a lot of people that go in. And again, Grace United Methodist Church Choir, Murphysboro United Methodist Church Choir. We have several scholarship recipients that are in the choir with us from SIU and from John A. Logan. So everybody makes this work, and it really does take a village. So I want to thank you all so much. And all contributions that you give during the year is what helped the scholarship program happen. And we need youth. We need young people in the congregation as well as in the choir to help us along. It's ministering. It's helping a lot of people. So thank you all so much, and have a good night.